शिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमास्मदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तिदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माणि दधाति गुरुं वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुम्हदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुरुवै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। आम्ना यान्तिकसंसिद्धमादिमध्यान्तवर्जितमानन्दघनमापूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। I think we were done with the 27th sutra. The 28th sutra introduction says, Nanu karma hanehe vidyaphalatve brahma prapte riva deha tyagottar kalinatvam syat atah. So the Purvapakshi is saying, if the vidyaphala, brahma vidyaphala is karma hani, what we saw in the earlier adhikarana, hanyadhikaranam, there we saw that the vidya karma, brahma vidya phala is karma hani. And in the next adhikarana, samparayadhikarana, we saw that the virajanadi tarana ityadi, which is mentioned, it is not that after the tarana of the viraja nadi there is karmakshaya, but the karma hani, karmakshaya is before mrityu itself, samparaya, because at the time of mrityu karma itself is not there, because as soon as the brahma vidya is successful, the upasaka jnani has karmakshaya, has karma hani. Now the Purvapakshi is saying, if at all karma hani is vidya phala, brahma vidya phala, then brahma prapte riva, how brahma loka attainment takes place, it is only after dropping the body. So brahma loka prapti, that is brahma prapti here. So that brahma prapte riva deha tyaga uttar kalinatvam syat, then the brahma prapti, which is a result of brahma vidya, brahma loka prapti as a result of brahma vidya, similarly this karma hani as a result of brahma vidya would be after dehatyaga, because brahma loka prapti is after dehatyaga and it is a result of brahma vidya. Similarly, if the karma hani is a result of brahma vidya, then it will also be after dehatyaga. Dehatyaga uttar kalinatvam syat kasya karma hani hai. Karma hani will definitely be after the dehatyaga, dropping the body, just like brahmaloka prapti. Atah, therefore Bhagavan sutrakara says, chandata ubhaya virodhat. So chandata here means ichha, due to ichha. Chanda means ichha here, so chandataha is पंचमी एक वचन इच्छातः, पंचमी अर्थ है तसिल, प्रत्यय हैज बीन यूज्ड, सेज इच्छातः, ड्यू टू इच्छा इट्सेल्फ, विद्या अनुष्ठानम जीवता एव, सो इट इज नॉट आफ्टर मरण, आफ्टर देह त्याग, बट जीवता एव, जीवन एव, जीवन्नेव मुक्ति ही जीवन मुक्ति ही. सिमिलरली दिस ब्रह्म विद्या फला ज्ञान विल रिजल्ट इन मुक्ति वाइल लिविंग इट्सेल्फ. बिकॉज द अनुष्ठान इज डन छंदतः इच्छा था, ड्यू टू इच्छा ऑफ अनर्थ निवृत्ति, निशेष अनर्थ निवृत्ति, दुख निवृत्ति एंड परमानंद प्राप्ति ब्रह्म प्राप्ति दैट वॉज द संकल्प विथ विच वन हैज डन श्रवण मनन निध्यासन ब्रह्म विद्या साधन वन हैज फॉलोड. सो दिस इच्छा फॉर अटेनिंग ब्रह्म इज देयर ड्यू टू विच वन हैज डन साधना ड्यूरिंग द लाइफ लाइफ टाइम इट्सेल्फ. सो वन कैन डू the anusthana and attain jnana not only in brahmaloka but here itself. So it is not that the brahma prapti riva, the brahma prapti in brahmaloka also there is brahma prapti. So brahma prapti, one meaning is attaining brahmaloka, but the main meaning is attainment of brahma, that brahma jnana takes place in brahmaloka also. It is easier in brahmaloka, but attaining brahmaloka is not easy. Now, if one can attain Brahmajnana in Brahmaloka, it doesn't mean that one will attain Brahmajnana and thereby Brahma only in Brahmaloka. One can attain it here also. Therefore, Chandataheva, one can do Brahmavidya sadhana following. One can follow the Brahmavidya sadhana here itself while living and not after the drop of the body in another loka. So that is the meaning of chandata. Due to Ichha, Vidya Anushthana is possible while living itself. And therefore, its result also can happen here itself. It is not that one is intending to attain the Karmahani and thereby Brahma Prapti elsewhere. One is expecting the result here itself as per the Shruti. It is not the Ananda is sought after only after Marana. Karma Kandi say that Ananda here and hereafter also. When they do karma for Swargaphala, that Swargaphala is Sukarupa. That Sukha need not be in another loka only. It is definitely in another loka primarily, but Sukha is intended here also. If one gets sukha only in another loka, that is of no use. The very idea of doing karma here with lot of dukkha is to get atyantika sukha. Some sukha you attain, even if it is a lot more than you attain here, that is not the end goal. So Siddhanti has always been saying, Uttar Mimamsaka has been countering Purva Mimamsaka all the while, saying that this sukha prapti as a phala is to be nitya. It has to be nitya. It cannot be where travel is involved and the travel back is also involved. We have seen that. As to wherever the travel is involved, that sukha will be limited. So who is this mumukshu? Mumukshu is one who is intending to attain nitya moksha, which is nitya ananda rupa. And therefore, it cannot be only elsewhere, attained elsewhere. It has to be attained here. If it is attained elsewhere, then it is not nitya. It should be attained in all desha, all kala. If it is only after dehatyaga, then it is not really something which is conducive to sadhana. The sadhana primary success of the sadhana is attaining ananda here and now. Therefore, chandata eva ubhaya avirodhat. Ubhaya avirodhat. This ubhaya avirodhat can be taken as the shrutis which are quoted. There is shruti, tandyadi shruti avirodha. Or it can be seen as Shruti Avirodha as well as Upapatti Avirodha, meaning the interpretation that the Siddhanti is doing as to, due to one's own Ichha, one is doing sadhana, the Ichha is to attain Ananda, Paramananda here, Brahma Prapti here itself. Since the sadhana for Brahma Prapti Sankalpa is to attain it here, therefore, sadhana is also here and phala is also here. And that is not opposed to Shruti nor is it opposed to logic. So it's tenable to attain here. As per the Shruti also, there is no virodha, and logically also it is appropriate. There is no virodha. So ubhaya avirodha. In both cases, Shruti as well as in logic, there is no contradiction. To logic and Shruti, there is no contradiction. The vritti, part of which we have already seen, chandataha svechataha vidya anushthanam jivata eva iti tad hetu karmakshayaha jivata eva yuktaha. It is yukta, it is tenable, but logical as to, since this sadhana is based on one's own ichcha to attain the result here and now, therefore while living the sadhana is there and while living itself the result is also attained. And tad hetuka karmakshaya, tad hetuka is vidya anushthanam hetuka, the vidya result, this vidya anushthana, the following the sadhana towards vidya is followed while living. So the result of that vidya, tad hetuka, vidya anushthana hetuka also and vidya hetuka also. Vidya is a result of anushthana, and vidya anushthana hetu, vidya anushthana hetuka. So vidya anushthanam hetuhu yasya karmakshayasya saha karmakshayaha tad hetuka, or vidya anushthanam hetukaha karmakshayaha. And karmanam kshayaha, karmakshaya is shashti tatpurusha. So tad hetuka is in bahuri with karmakshaya. Karmakshaya itself is shashti tatpurusha. And tat here stands for vidya, or vidya anushthanam, both are possible. Basically vidya, because vidya, result of vidya is karmakshaya, not of vidya anushthana. Anushthana should fructify into vidya. Sadhana should fructify into vidya. So tat primarily stands for vidya, brahma vidya. And that is not possible without anushthana, which is done while living. Therefore, its result is also as expected and as planned and as sankalpita. It is while living itself. Jivata eva yukta, it is but logical as to attaining the result also while living. Why? Why do you say so? There are many karmas and upasanas. Most of them give adrushta, and that adrushta fructifies only in a later life or after dropping the body. So why would you say that this Brahma Vidya phala is such a phala that is attained only while living and not later, or it is appropriate that it will, logical that it will be attained during the lifetime itself of the sadhaka and not later? Why would you say so, ask the Purva Bhakshi. To that Siddhanti says, sati hetu karya vilamba ayogat. Sati hetu, hetu sati. If the hetu is there, when the hetu is there, then why will phala be delayed? Karya, when karana is there, then karya vilamba is not appropriate. Ayogya, it is not proper that when everything is present, every karana is present and karya does not take place. That is not possible. If the kulala has mrut available, water available, danda chakra, so all this is available, he has intention to create the ghata, he has made the chakra move with danda, he has placed the, mixed the dry mud with water and made clay, he has placed the clay on the chakra, all this he has done. He has shaped the clay also while the chakra is moving. There is enough heat to dry the clay which has been given the shape of the pot, and then if you insist, says the Siddhanti to the Purva Pakshi, all these karanas are present, and now if you insist that the pot will not take place immediately, soon after, that is not right. Karya vilamba ayoga. Ayogat. Karyasya vilambasya ayogat. When every karana is present, why would karya not take place? देयर इज एब्सोल्युटली नो रीजन फॉर प्रारब्धा टू गेट ओवर द बॉडी टू ड्रॉप ऑफ वन टू ट्रेवल टू ब्रह्मलोका और बी हियर इटसेल्फ एंड देन व्हेन वन इज नॉट एम्बॉडीड देन द रिजल्ट फ्रक्टिफाइज देयर इज नो सच लॉजिक एट ऑल इट मेक्स नो सेंस दैट एवरी कारण विद्या ब्रह्म विद्या हैज बीन सक्सेसफुल ही हैज डन the upasana as intended, he has done shravana mana nididhyasana as intended. So karma, upasana and shravana mana nididhyasana, all these are sadhanas, karanas which have been followed to the word. And then you say that no, now you have to wait till the drop of the body to attain the karmahani, that is not necessary, that is not logically logically right as well, it's not tenable. So sati heto karya vilamba ayogat, here and now itself the result of karma hani is attained, because this jnana is like, is compared with agni. We see in Gita also jnana agni bhasmasat kurute, it completely karsnena भस्मं कुरुते कार्ष्णेन, दैट सातिंग प्रत्यय इज इन कार्ष्ण्य अर्थ, कंप्लीटली बर्न्स टू आशेस, नन ऑफ इट इज लेफ्ट, सो ऑल द कर्मज आर बर्न टू आशेस, सर्व कर्माणि एक्सेप्ट प्रारब्ध ऑफ कोर्स. सो एवं सती, सो दैट बीइंग सो, एवं सती विद्या कर्म क्षयोः निमित्त नैमित्तिक भावे तांड्यादि श्रुत्योः उभयोः अविरोधः भवति इत्यर्थः. सो दिस अश्वैव रुमाणि इत्यादि हैज बीन कोटेड, सो ऑल दीज विच आर कोटेड अर्लियर, वॉट एवर श्रुतिज आर कोटेड, दोज श्रुतिज आर नॉट अपोज एट ऑल विद दिस इंटरप्रिटेशन. Therefore, Tandyadi Shrutyoho Ubhayoho Avirodha. There is no Virodha to the Tandyadi Shrutis quoted. And logically also, if you say all Shrutis put together, there is no Virodha at all. And logically also, that can also be explained. So, Avirodha Bhavati Ityartha. And then logical opposition is also not there. That is shown by the next sentence. Brahma Praptehe Deha Tyagam Vina अनुपपत्ते हे प्रकृते च अनुपपत्य भावात जीवतेव कर्मक्षयः इति भावः. सो व्हाट द पूर्व पक्षी सेड एज टू ब्रह्म प्राप्ति, ब्रह्मलोक प्राप्ति इज ओनली आफ्टर ड्रॉपिंग द बॉडी एंड इट इज आल्सो द रिजल्ट ऑफ ब्रह्म विद्या उपासना. सो सिमिलरली दिस ब्रह्म विद्या फला बीइंग कर्महानि, इन कर्महानि बीइंग ब्रह्म विद्या फला, therefore just like the brahma vidya phala, that is brahmaloka, which is attained after the dropping of the body, similarly this karma kshaya also should be after the dropping of the body. That is not right. Why? Because in one case it is impossible to attain brahmaloka bodily, in another case attaining karma kshaya absolutely has no need of dropping the body, it can be attained with the body also. संचिता एंड आगामी कर्म क्षय कैन बी अटेन्ड विद द बॉडी, प्रारब्ध क्षय कैन नॉट बी अटेन्ड. प्रारब्ध क्षय इफ इट टेक्स प्लेस बॉडीली देन बॉडी इटसेल्फ विल ड्रॉप ऑफ, वंस एसोसिएशन विद प्रारब्ध गोज अवे. बट वी हैव सीन संचिता एंड आगामी आर डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड टू अदर्स, विच इज व्हाट द श्रुति इज, व्हाइल लिविंग इटसेल्फ इट इज डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड टू अदर्स. द ज्ञानी उपासक ज्ञानी पुण्य पाप इज डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड टू द रिस्पेक्टिव फॉलोअर्स और दोज हु आर इंसल्टिंग और टॉर्चरिंग दी ज्ञानी, ट्रबलिंग दी ज्ञानी उपासक. सो इट इज वाइल लिविंग इट सेल्फ. हाउएवर दिस ब्रह्मलोक प्राप्ति इज नॉट पॉसिबल विदाउट देहत्याग. सो ब्रह्म प्राप्ते हे ब्रह्मलोक प्राप्ते हे देहत्यागम विना अनुपपत्ते हे, बिकॉज ब्रह्मलोका कैनॉट बी अटेन्ड विदाउट देहत्याग. देयरफॉर व्हाट, इवन इफ इट इज ब्रह्म विद्या फला, ब्रह्म उपासना फला, One has to wait till the drop of the body to attain Brahmaloka. There is no other way out. However, prakrute cha anupatya bhavat. In the context we are talking about Brahma Vidya phala, which is karmakshaya, that does not have to wait till the drop of the body. So there is no anupapatti there. There is no untenability. There is no illogicality there. So anupapatya abhavat jivata eva, while living itself, karmakshaya iti bhavaha, the karmahani takes place while living itself, and thereby the phala is immediate. Itham prasangikam vidya udayanantaram eva karmahanim, karmahanam ityabhidhaya yathahana sannidhau kvachit shruyamanam upayanam sarvatra upasamhriyate tatha. Purvapakshi is looking into the process in which the Siddhanti has analyzed, and thereby he brings in something similar, drishtanta sangati. So itham, in this manner, prasangikam vidya, prasangikam, in the, you know, it's a topic which is ongoing, and on a related note you bring in something. So this was discussed in passing as to what vidya udaya anantaram eva. The karma hana or hani takes place, karmakshaya takes place, vidya udaya anantaram eva, immediately after the rise of vidya, brahma vidya, karma hani takes place. The doubtless knowledge, the upasana completely fructifying, after the jnanotpatti basically. So this brahma vidya, again we have seen there are two interpretations. One is upasana and one is jnana. In both cases it is applicable. If the brahma vidya, which is an upasana, leads to brahmaloka, then also karmakshaya may take place, but brahma jnana will definitely result in karmakshaya while living itself. So vidya udayanantaram eva karmahanam ityabhidhaya, having stated that, or established, Siddhanti has established, having established that karmahani takes place while living itself after the utpatti of vidya, yathahana sannidhau kvachit shruyamanam upayanam sarvatra upasamhriyate. And based on this, what has been done? This was the thinking, although it came up later in the sutra. Siddhanti was thinking that while living itself, karmahani takes place. Therefore, the tyaga that is done by the jnani upasaka and the picking up of the upadana, upayana, which is done by the others, the punya papa that accrues to the others, picked up by the others, is also while living itself, while the jnani is living. So what is being said is that the tyaga and upayanam, upadana, should go hand in hand. If one is missing, the other should be brought in. They have ekavakyata. So hana sannidhau kvachit shruyamanam upayanam, the upayana which is heard in the proximity of hana, in any shruti, across shakhas or within the shakha, sarvatra upasamhriyate, upasamhara should be done all over, across shrutis, both ways. Tatha hana sannidhau kvachit shruyamanah devayanah pantaha sarvatra upasamhartaveti drishtanta sangatya idamah. Similarly, the Purvapakshi now says that in the proximity of the punya papa tyaga, as heard in swashakha hana sannidhi, in that hana sannidhi, in the close proximity of that hana, kvachit shruyamana, somewhere it is heard in swashakha or elsewhere in another shakha, what is heard? Devayana pantaha, the path which is path towards what? It is means to attain devaloka. So that devayana pantaha, people go by the devayana. Who is that upasaka, who saguna upasaka, brahma vidyas saguna brahma upasaka, who is giving up punya and papa? So hana sannidhi is there, in the proximity of that hana, dropping up of punya and papa, dropping off punya and papa, in that proximity there is a sentence which says, or words which talk about that upasakas travel after dropping the body to devaloka itya devayana pantaha. So these paths are heard, that also should be clubbed together elsewhere where it is not heard. There is eka vakyata in the same shakha or another shakha, you have to bring this to hana sandhi. What does it mean? It means that after dropping of the body, even if the karma hani has taken place while living, as claimed by the siddhanti in the earlier adhikarana or multiple adhikaranas also, even so there is gati involved. The upasaka as well as saguna upasaka as well as a nirguna brahma jnani, both will have to travel. There is travel involved. Brahma loka devayana, so devaloka, brahma loka is also considered in the same path. So the travel is involved. This has to be clubbed together. This result should be clubbed together where it is not heard in that shakha also. You have to bring it together, says the Purva Pakshi. And even if it is in the same shakha, there is eka vakyata. If it is heard elsewhere, whether it's in same shakha or in not in same shakha, somewhere it is in the same shakha and it is in close proximity to the hana, punya papa, dropping off by the upasaka, that should be clubbed together elsewhere also, says the Purva Pakshi. Iti drishtanta sangatya idamaha. Thereby the gater artha vatvadikarana comes up. So gati, the brahmaloka, devaloka gati, that gati is the path, pantha, that is meaningful, arthavatva. So there is meaningfulness in the gati which is discussed in the various shakhas in the proximity of punya papa hana, karma hana, karmakshaya. The sutra there, Bhagavan Sutrakara says, gater arthavattvam ubhayatanyathahi virodaha. गतेर अर्थवत्त्वम् उभयतान्यथा हि विरोधः. सो गतेः अर्थवत्त्वम् उभयथा, इन बोथ उभयथा, बोथ केसेस, गति बोथ केसेस मीनिंग सगुण उपासक एंड निर्गुण उपासक और निर्गुण ज्ञानी ब्रह्मज्ञानी. सो सगुण निर्गुण उपासक एंड ब्रह्मज्ञानी हु इज निर्गुण ब्रह्मज्ञानी. In both cases, ubhayata, what? Gatehe arthavattvam. Brahmaloka devayana pantaha gatehe arthavattvam. That one travels after dropping the body, whether he is an upasaka of saguna brahma or he is nirguna brahma jnani, in both cases, it is meaningful. This gati is meaningful. Travel is meaningful. Anyatha, why? Anyatha hi virodha. Otherwise, anyatha hi virodha, says the Purva Pakshi there. This is one way to look at the sutra from Purva Pakshi's perspective. But from the Siddhanti perspective, what is the sutra really saying? Gatehe arthavattu ubhayata is not in both case. Ubhayata, actually ubhayata is in both ways. So gati is not only meaningful. I explained the Purva Paksha looking at the sutra, but the sutra is actually Siddhanti sutra. So what is Siddhanti really saying? Ubhayatha, Purva Pakshi is claiming that it has to be clubbed together. Siddhanti is saying, no, gati has to be meaningful, right? I will show you how gati is meaningful. Ubhayatha, it is meaningful. Anyatha hi virodha, shruti virodha will be there. In the anyatha hi virodha is Siddhanti saying, and how is he explaining? He is saying gati is meaningful in both ways. In both ways means arthavattvam, gati is meaningful if the upasaka is a saguna upasaka or a nirguna upasaka. It is an upasaka. For him, the in both ways it is meaningful. सगुण निर्गुण विभागेन उभयता उभयता थल प्रत्यय देयर इज प्रकारवाची थल इन बोथ वेज इट इज मीनिंगफुल वेदर इट इज अ ज्ञानी बीइंग डेल्ट विथ निर्गुण ब्रह्म ज्ञानी और सगुण ब्रह्म उपासका इन बोथ केसेस उभयता गति ही इज अर्थवती गते है अर्थवत्व अदरवाइज विल बी श्रुति विरोध हाउ बोथ वेज इट इज मीनिंगफुल दैट विल सी इन दी वृत्ति आई डोंट वांट टू रिपीट इट शॉर्ट वृत्ति सो तत्र पूर्वपक्षे निर्गुण विदः अपि मुक्त्यर्थं मार्गापेक्षा सिद्धांते तु अनपेक्षा इति फलभेद पूर्वपक्षी इज सेइंग दैट फॉर दी निर्गुण ब्रह्म विद्वान ऑल्सो देर इज डिपेंडेंसी ऑन मार्ग मार्गापेक्षा आफ्टर द ड्रॉप ऑफ द बॉडी फॉर वॉट पर्पज फॉर द पर्पज ऑफ मुक्ति मुक्त्यर्थं Moksha is not going to result bodily. One has to travel. Then only mukti will be possible even for a nirguna brahma jnani. Siddhanti says it is not so. In Siddhanta, what is the case? To anapeksha iti phalabheda. Marga anapeksha. There is no dependency in a marga in which on which marga he travels. There is no travel at all, let alone which marga. There is no dependency on in which kala he should do dehatyaga. Whether it should be in Uttarayana, only or can he do in Dakshinayana also can the brahmajnani drop the body only does he have to drop the body only during the daytime or can it be during the night also can it be on amavasya ityadi can be on ashubha dina none of that matters because all these kalas gati ayana all these are meaningless for the brahmajnani so there is no apeksha There is no dependency on any marga. Marga ityadi. Marga is just an upalakshana here. For a siddhanti we can read, there is no dependency on anything. But specifically in the sutra, marga is being pointed out by the Purvapakshi. Siddhanti says that the shruti will in fact be meaningful and there will be no virodha only when we take this division into account. In one case, gati is involved, and in another case, gati is not involved. So, ubhayata meaning, in both cases, nirguna brahma jnani not traveling, and saguna brahma upasaka traveling, in both cases, the gati is meaningful. So, gati, meaning the mention of the gati is meaningful only when the saguna brahma upasaka travels, and the nirguna brahma upasaka does not travel. Why? Because otherwise Shruti Virodha will be there. Shruti specifically says that the Nirguna Brahma Upasaka does not travel. So that we will see in the Vritti further. Karmahana Sannidhav Kvachit Devayanav Pantaha Shrutaha Kvachin Na Shrutaha Nirguna Vidya Nirguna Brahma Vidya Stale Nirguna Vidya Stale So in the place of Nirguna Brahma Vidya in such situations and such cases or such sections in the Jnana Kanda There is no marga heard. Devayana marga is not heard. Siddhanti is saying that is meaningful as it is. No travel is involved. Purvapakshi says you bring the travel from the Saguna Brahma Upasaka Kanda, Upasana Kanda into Jnana Kanda. So, Kvachit Devayana Pantha Shrutaha. So, there is some places when the Karmahani is heard, Karmahana Sannidhau, there Kvachit Devayana Pantha Shrutaha. So, it is heard. That can be brought in. Tatra kim devayana upasamhara asti na vaiti sande asti iti purvapaksha. Purvapaksha says you have to club together that marga of travel into the nirguna brahma vidya jnana kanda also. Siddhantastu. Whereas Siddhanta is gatehe devayanasya pataha arthavattvam ubhayata. In both cases of upasana and jnana, Meaning Saguna Brahma Upasana and Nirguna Brahma Jnana Arthavattvam Gati Devayana Devayanasya Pataha The Marga leading to Devaloka Brahmaloka is meaningful. How? Vibhagena. Vibhagena Bhavitum Arhati. You have to see on a case-to-case basis. Is he an Upasaka? Yes. Okay. Then Devayana Pantha that path will be applicable. But if he is not an upasaka, then vibhagena, there is no travel. Just because the marga is there, and travel is involved for Upasaka does not mean that the other one who is a jnani will have travel. Kvachit saguna vidyayam devayana marga asti, kvachit nirguna vidyayam na iti. So this is the vibhaga. Gati is meaningful. Just because gati is not applicable for a brahmajnani, nirguna brahmajnani, does not mean that it is not applicable and it is not meaningful. It is meaningful. In fact, this is the only way it is meaningful, that the upasaka travels and the jnani does not travel. Anyatha, otherwise what will happen? Siddhanti says there is shruti virodha. Hi virodha sarvatra devayana marga upasamhara angikare vidvan punya pape viduya niranjanah paramam samy upaiti iti shruti virodha syat. Please give me a moment. There is somebody at the door. Okay. विभागेन भवितुमर्हति क्वचित् सगुण विद्यायां देवयान मार्गः अस्ति क्वचित् निर्गुण विद्यायां न इति. सो दिस इज द डिविजन इन विच दि गति विल बी मीनिंगफुल. अन्यथा सर्वत्र देवयान मार्ग उपसंहार अंगीकारे. अन्यथा अदरवाइज व्हाट विल हैपन. अन्यथा ऑल्सो से उभयता इज इन बोथ मैनर्स प्रकारवाची. अन्यथा था ऑल्सो हियर इज प्रकारवाची. अदरवाइज इफ यू टेक अ डिफरेंट अप्रोच as the Purva Pakshi is taking, then what will happen? Sarvatra Devayana Marga Upasamhara Angikara. When you do Angikare Sati, if you accept that you have to club together the travel where it is not mentioned also in Jnana Kanda, then what will happen? Vidvan Punya Pape Viduyaha, Vidvan Punya Pape Viduya Niranjanah Paramam Samyam Upaiti. Paramam Samyam Upaiti. So Paramam Samyam, it can be seen in multiple ways. We'll take a simple meaning as to Ekatva. Or elsewhere it is seen as to, you know, let there be Samya. So why Paramam Samya has been mentioned? So Samya is there even in Dvaita. In Dvaita the Samya is similarity. But Paramam Samyam is same, that is Ekatva. So somebody prays, you know, we have seen in this Puranas etc. Avatara takes place because someone prays that I want to be born. I want Bhagwan to be born in, I want Bhagwan to be born as my son or something like that. We have seen such kind of things whereby Sat Janma is seen and avatara of Bhagavan is seen. So there this Paramam Samyam may be possible. Meaning what? Kashchana prarthayati. He Bhagavan tadvat putram icchami iti. I desire son like you. So there Paramam Samya. Bhagavan is not born completely. There is an Ausha which is born. So that is the Samya. So tada Bhagavan eva putra rupena jayate. But that Bhagavan eva jayate, there evakara should be understood as Amsha. We don't see 100% Bhagavan born. Purna can never be separated completely from Purna. Even if you remove Purna, Purna remains. So we have seen this Shanti Mantra, Purna Mada Ityadi. So there Samya is similarity in Amsha. Avataras also, because bodily there are some limitations. Avatara is because of prayers by others for their own results, not for Bhagavan wanting anything. Somebody else, samashti, many people pray that Bhagavan be born for some result, or one person prays and his prayer is successful because of such karma in across janmas. And there may be, you know, some avatara which is not discussed. Avataras mentioned, they are all upalakshana. It is not that there is only, you know, n number of avataras, dasha avatara ityadi. That is not true. There are many manifestations of Bhagavan in many forms. This is all upalakshana. 10 avataras are just upalakshana. देर आर मेनी अंशाज मेनी डिग्रीज ऑफ मैनिफेस्टेशन ऑफ भगवान. इनफैक्ट एवरी जीवा इज ऑल्सो एन अवतार. इन सम माइन्यूट फ्रैक्शन देर इज अवतरण. Therefore, paramam samyam upaiti has been mentioned attains niranjanaha, being free from all karma papa, vidvan punya pape viduya, having given up all punya and papa, being untainted. Niranjanaha, son, paramam samyam upaiti ekatvam gacchati ityartha, attains ekatva, ekatvam labhate. Iti shruti virodhasyat, this shruti, when it says ekatva, one has become one with Brahma, then it is like saying Paramatma travels. Parabrahma cannot travel. Parabrahma is Vyapaka Tattva. Once this Brahma Veda Brahmayo Bhavati or Vidvan Punyapape Viduya Niranjana Paramam Samya Upaiti Ekatvam, one has become non-different. One with, become is figurative. One knows that I was always Brahma, one with Brahma, then in this ekatva being mentioned, there cannot be any travel. So that shruti will be opposed. Iti shruti virodasyat. Ataha nirguna vidyaya marga upasamhara vyartha ityartha. Therefore, in nirguna brahma vidya, you cannot bring this marga, etc., and club it together. That is vyartha. It is futile. Ityartha. Nanutari saguna vidyaya api margo vyartha sya ityataha. Purvapakshi says, then why do you say that ubhayata, it is, what you said, ubhayata arthavattvam. How is there arthavattvam? Why not say that gati is meaningless even for a saguna brahma upasaka? To that, Siddhanti Sutrakara says, upapannastallakshanartho उपलब्धेहे तल्लक्षणार्थोपलब्धेहे इज वन वर्ड लोकवत. सो उपपन्नः गति कारण प्रयोजनस्य श्रुतिषु उपलब्धेहे, दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ तल्लक्षणार्थोपलब्धेहे. तल्लक्षण अर्थ उपलब्धि इज देयर, देयर इज अ उपलब्धि ऑफ अर्थ ऑफ तल्लक्षण. देयरफॉर उपपन्नः, दिस इज द हेतु फॉर उपपन्न. उपपन्न इज व्हाट वी हैव interpreted, that gati is there for upasakas, not for jnanis. That is tenable. Why? Tallakshanarthopalabdehe. We look at, so what is this samasa? It's a bahurihi. So sa gatihi lakshanam, lakshanam meaning karanam. So tat means sa gatihi, that gati, tad gatihi. So tad gatihi, the devayana pantha gati, brahmaloka gati, और देवलोक गति बेस्ड ऑन द उपासना, दैट गति इज लक्षण. लक्षण इज कारण. कारण यस्य, कारणम यस्य, यस्य कस्य, यस्य सगुण विद्या फलस्य. दैट गति, दैट पाथ इज कारण फॉर व्हाट, टू अटेन द देवलोक और ब्रह्मलोक. सो इट्स अ पाथ, इट्स अ मार्ग. सो मार्ग गति इज द कारण लक्षण टू अटेन देवलोक और ब्रह्मलोक. एंड व्हाट इज दैट, दैट ब्रह्मलोक और देवलोक इज द उपासना फल, सगुण विद्या फल. सो सगुण विद्या फल विच इज देवलोक ब्रह्मलोक, दैट इज अटेन्ड ओनली बाय दिस गति, बाय दिस मार्ग. देयरफॉर तल्लक्षणार्थ उपलब्धेहे. सो व्हाट इज दैट, दैट इज तल्लक्षणार्थ एंड तस्य श्रुतिषु उपलब्धे. तस्य कस्य, तल्लक्षणार्थस्य, दैट इज तल्लक्षणार्थ इज बहुरी एंड देन तल्लक्षणार्थो उपलब्धि इज षष्ठी तत्पुरुष. सो तस्य तल्लक्षणार्थस्य श्रुतिषु उपलब्धे, बिकॉज इट इज देयर इन श्रुति. श्रुति टॉक्स अबाउट दिस. देयरफॉर उपपन्न इट इज लॉजिकल. यू कैनॉट यूज यूर ओन माइंड एंड कंक्लूड without any basis, that shushka tarka does not work. So upapannaha, this upapatti or yukti, the logic which has been presented is based on the shruti, not on shushka, meaningless pratyakshadi or some comparative that you have in your mind. None of that is going to work. जस्ट बिकॉज इट इज नॉट मीनिंगफुल, गति इज नॉट मीनिंग फॉर निर्गुण विद्या, सो इट लेट इट नॉट बी मीनिंगफुल फॉर सगुण विद्या ऑल्सो. इफ दिस इज ए क्लेम बाय पूर्व पक्षी, दैट काइंड ऑफ अ थिंकिंग विल नॉट वर्क. देर इज नो बेसिस टू सच थिंकिंग. अवर थिंकिंग एंड प्रेजेंटेशन इज उपपन्न, इज लॉजिकल. वाई? बिकॉज इट इज बेस्ड इन श्रुति. दैट इज द बेसिक अर्थ देयर. एंड तल्लक्षणार्थ उपलब्ध इज बिकॉज दिस फला विच इज अटेनेबल टू ओनली अ सगुण विद्या उपासका, इट इज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ सगुण विद्या. इट कैन बी अटेंड ओनली दैट लोका इज अ रिजल्ट विच इज प्रॉमिस्ड बाय द श्रुति. एंड द श्रुति सेज दैट दिस लोका इज अटेनेबल ओनली थ्रू दिस मार्ग. सो ऑल द रूल्स विच आर एप्लीकेबल, दे आर टू बी फॉलोड एंड दे हैव टू बी अंडरस्टूड इन दिस वेरी मैनर एज टू हाउ द उपासका ट्रेवल्स वेन ही लीव्स द बॉडी. All this is meaningful there as per the Shruti. Since it is available in the Shruti in this manner, it is Parama Pramana. There is no counter to it. And then Loka Vata. What is Loka Vata? Just like in Loka. See, Vritti is very easy. I'll go to the Vritti directly. I don't want to repeat this Loka Vata. It is very simple. So, Gatehe Ubhayata Bhavaha Upapanna. Ubhayata Bhava is Bhava and Abhava. सो गति भाव एंड गति अभाव. गति भाव फॉर हुम? फॉर उपासक. एंड गति अभाव फॉर हुम? फॉर ज्ञानी. उपपन्न इट इज टेनेबल. वाय? तल्लक्षणार्थ उपलब्धे, दैट इज ए हेतु. व्हाट इज दैट? वी ऑलरेडी सीन. सा गति ही लक्षण कारण यस्य सगुण विद्याफलस्य पर्यवस्थ ब्रह्म प्राप्ति रूपस्य. दैट ब्रह्म विच ब्रह्मलोक, ब्रह्म प्राप्ति इज ब्रह्मलोक प्राप्ति, देवलोक प्राप्ति विच इज एल्सवेयर. That is stationary elsewhere. It is the Brahmaloka is not coming here. You cannot be in Brahmaloka without traveling. You the Upasaka. Therefore, Parevastha Brahma Prapti Rupasya Saguna Vidyapalasya. That which is elsewhere has to be attained through Marga. You cannot say that there is this place and there is no way to reach that. The way is discussed, the Loka is discussed as a result. So somebody says that, okay, you will get a parish trip. They say parish trip. So, with some competition, you win a Paris trip. But then, there is no way to reach Paris is not the case. You need a marga there. So, that Paris is not going to come here. They are not going to bring and give you Paris. So, you have to reach there. How do you reach there? Some marga has to be there. So, marga is also given only for one who has travel involved. And travel is possible only if there is separation. The separation is definitely there. Paris is separate from this desha. सो परिवस्त ब्रह्म प्राप्ति रूपस्य सगुण विद्या फलस्य गति इज कारण. विदाउट मार्ग इट कैनॉट बी अटेन्ड. एंड दैट लोका इज द रिजल्ट ऑफ दिस सगुण विद्या. सो सगुण विद्या उपासक हैज टू यूज द मार्ग टू रीच दैट लोका. सो तल्लक्षणार्थ तस्य श्रुतिषु उपलब्धे. बिकॉज इट इज अवेलेबल इन दिस मैनर इट्सेल्फ. ओनली इन दिस मैनर इट इज प्रेजेंटेड इन द श्रुति, रिवील्ड इन द श्रुति. अतः सगुण विद्याया मार्ग अर्थवान. Therefore, this marga is meaningful for saguna vidya, but not for nirguna vidya as seen earlier. Just because it is not meaningful in nirguna vidya, you should not say, be it so for saguna vidya also. Na, nirguna vidyayam. Lokavat. Example given is, like in loka, what is that? Yatha loke setu asinam ganga praptyartham margo apekshitaha na ganga sthanam tadvattityartha. So somebody who is Setuvasi, Setu is Ramasetu, that we know Ramasetu. This Ramasetu, which is in the southmost part of Bharata Desha, those who are staying there, they want to have Ganga Snana. Ganga is not available there. You have to go in Uttara Desha. You have to go in Uttara Pradesha, Uttara Desha of Bharata. सो गंगा प्राप्ति अर्थम मार्ग अपेक्षित. बट दोज हु आर स्टेइंग एट गंगा, फॉर देम इज देयर मार्ग नीडेड. दे आर ऑन द बैंक्स ऑफ गंगा, नियर गंगा, सो देयर इज नो मार्ग नीडेड. दे आर ऑन द बैंक्स ऑफ गंगा, देयर नो मार्ग इज एक्सपेक्टेड. सिमिलरली सगुण विद्या, दोज हु वॉन्ट टू रीच ब्रह्मलोक, फॉर देम मार्ग इज नीडेड. बट दोज हु हैव नोन देयर स्वरूप एज ब्रह्म, there is no need to reach Brahmaloka at all. Just like in the Paris example, Paris is given to the marga to reach Paris is meaningful for those who are not in Paris. Those who are already in Paris, for them there is no marga needed. Tadvat ityartha. Similar is the case here. Thereby this adhikarna is over. We look at the next adhikarna in the next part. आम्नायन्ते समसिद्धमादि मध्यान्त वर्जितम आनंद घनम अपूर्णम आत्म ज्योति रूपास्महे. नमस्ते. धन्यवाद.
धन्यवाद. नमस्ते.